Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to look about how you can record eBay managed payments into QuickBooks Self-Employed. Hello, my name is Adam Patrick. I'm a chartered accountant, certified UK trainer, and also that QuickBooks chap. After my latest video about recording eBay managed payments, one of the things you guys reached out to me on was, well, how do I put that into QuickBooks Self-Employed? And hence why we're doing this video. So just to recap, what is eBay managed payment, I hear you all ask? Well, effectively, if you now sell items on eBay, like this little fella here, then when you do sell that item, you're now going to be prompted, or at some point you will be forced to receive the money via eBay managed payment, as opposed to PayPal, which used to be the default before. Now, as I said in the last video, eBay managed payments does have its advantages. It gives you a chance to pay by Apple Pay and everything else that goes with it. Like the fact that your fees and everything are deducted at source. So that should help with cash flow because there's no need to actually pay for anything later down the line. And overall, it does feel like the fees are going to be less for us as resellers, because when you look at the combined fee of eBay and eBay managed payments compared to eBay and PayPal, it's slightly in our favor. Disadvantage of that though, is that because we're eliminating PayPal, when it comes to recording the transactions, we're gonna have to be a little bit more savvy about it. And that's what I'm gonna look at today, how we record those transactions and how we put those transactions into QuickBooks. So let's have a look at it now. Okay, so I'm gonna use the same guy that I sold last time. So last time I talked about selling this little fella. And as you can see here, Walt Disney 9-inch Winnie the Pooh was sold for £6.99 plus £6.99 was sold for, £2.85 postage, giving me a grand total of £9.84. So when it comes to selling, I need to record £9.84. But why £9.84? Why is that so important? Well, when it comes to accounting, we care about that gross sale. Now, technically, if you're going to look at it into categories and everything else, you'd probably want your postage and your actual selling to be separate, because that way you could look and make sure that you are charging the right amount for your postage compared to actually how much is taking or how much you're paying out in postage, so that you can look at how much you're paying postage and how much you're paying for postage and materials. And you can make sure from a business point of view that if you take how much you're charging for postage less how much you're paying out for postage, that you're making profit or at least breaking even. So it could be useful for you to split them out. But in this video, we're going to keep it nice and simple. And all we care about is showing that £9.84, because it's that £9.84, which is how much we sold this little fella for. Now, the reason it's important is because that £9.84 is what we call our gross sales. And gross sales is critical to when you're doing a tax return and when you're doing your separate account and doing your bookkeeping. Also, that gross sale is what is related to when it comes to VAT. And if you're anywhere near that VAT threshold, so currently around about 85K, if you're currently anywhere near that, you need to be very precise in the way you record your income. If you were only recording what hits the bank account, and remember it's gonna take the fees and everything off there, then at that point you'll be under declaring your income, and therefore you won't be showing the right amount when it comes to VAT and also for your tax return. We need to show in QuickBooks that we've received £9.84. That's the important bit. And we need this £9.84 to be shown in QuickBooks. So our trick, our task today is to get £9.85 of income for this little fella. When I look at QuickBooks, I have the option to go in and look at the information in a little bit more detail. And I can see the payment details, and it will take me to the exact transaction where I received the money. Now, if I go to my payout ID, you'll see that there is my £8.19, my payout ID, and I can download report. When I download the report, I get loads and loads and loads and loads and loads of information. But the bit I'm interested in, here's my £8.19, that's my net amount that's gonna come into my bank. Here though is my £9.84, so my £6.99 and my postage and packaging. And as I keep going, here are the bits that become critical. £1.65 worth of fees. And if I take the £1.65 off this one, so I add them both together, you'll see I'm back to £8.19, which is the amount that I will receive in my bank account. And if I look at my bank statement, I will see £8.19 as received into my bank account. Again, and this is critical, not £9.84 what I sold for this particular item. And it's £9.84 I need to show in my books. So in QuickBooks, I need to be able to show that the figure's been grossed up. And that's what we're gonna look at now. We're gonna look at how do we show that I get to £9.84. So here I am in QuickBooks Self-Employed. And in QuickBooks Self-Employed, I would want to jump into my transactions view. So over here in the left-hand side. And I want to find that transaction that's related to it. Now I'm banking with Revolut for this particular example. Now, as an added complication, because I'm using Revolut, you can see here, I've got a screenshot of my Revolut account and Revolut has received £8.19 into the bank account. Problem is, Revolut has also taken 20p off me as a transactional charge because it's Revolut. And you won't have this with any other type of bank account. But with Revolut, they also take into account transactional charges, which for me was 20p. So I have an even more added complication in that I've not just got to show the transaction of my eBay fees, but I've also got to take into account my bank fees as well. Now, you just need to keep an eye on your bank account. Are you receiving the money in gross? And then if you do have bank charges, are they just taken out later? Or is the money already going to be deducted by bank fees? Either way, you've got to make sure the end result is that you're showing £9.84 for this transaction. So again, I've got some added complication. I've got £8.19 that should have come through the bank, but actually I only got £7.99 because 20p of it was for bank fees. So I need to account for not just the fact that I've got eBay fees, but also my bank fee as well. Now you have a choice here. You can, again, split that transaction into two different ones, but because they are all fees, I'm going to put them all in as one element. So I'm going to put my adjustment to correct. So here's my £7.99 that's hit my bank account, and I'm happy that I've got £7.99. So first things first, I've got to record this transaction as income. So it's coming in, and I've not 100% figured out why it's coming in as Aiden NV, but every transaction that comes from eBay managed payment is coming through as Aiden NV. So that's what you're looking out for. And I want to put this as business. Now I can set this as a rule, so every time that it comes in, it automatically gets put to business income. And I'm happy that it's business income. So if I need to, I can add a rule and I could set that to business income. Once I'm happy with that, I press save. And now that transaction is currently showing as £7.99. So at the moment, I've got majority of the income in there. But again, I haven't accounted for the fees yet. So that's what we're gonna do next. My critical date here is 13th of the 8th, 2020. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna add a new transaction. And that transaction is gonna be for the 13th of the 8th. And it's gonna be my eBay managed payment and bank fees. And if I want to here, I can put my receipt in. So I'm going to browse. What I would tend to do here as well is I would include here my transaction report. And I could even put my transaction ID here. So we have a transaction ID of, and for my own benefit, I'm going to put my payout ID just here. Press save. Now what I need to do is show the other entry of it. So I've put my income in as £1.85 to bring me back to that magical £9.84. Now I'm going to put an expense in exactly the same as £1.85, but this time negative. And all I'm going to do is put it against bank charges. So now if I look at the 13th of the 8th in totality, I've got £7.99 income, £1.85 income, and £1.85 as an expense. Now, I know that I've received the right amount of money into my bank account, which is £7.99. But if I was to run a report and look at the report and I run the right report, 13th, then crucially, I've got the right figure. I'm showing £10 or £9.84 if I was to click into it as my total income. And then I'm showing my fees of £2 against it. So let's recap how I achieved that. If I look at my turnover, I'm showing my £7.99 that came into my bank account, but then I'm putting a £1.85 as additional business income using the add transaction button. And to get my expenses right, I'll jump into expenses and I have my £1.85 against bank charges. Again, using the add transaction button up here. And that gives me my £8 profit because I've made £8. And that shows £8 net as I've received as profit, if you like. Whereas I've also shown my total gross sales and my total charges. Now, I know this is long-winded, and I know this is something that we need to look at ways in which we can make this much easier for us to manage. And that's what I'm going to do next. So on a video coming up is I'm going to look at how we can automate this as best as we possibly can. Now for QuickBooks Online, so the full version of QuickBooks, we do have options in there to connect what's called third-party apps, and all this can be done automatically for us. I'm going to explore that and have a look at that. When it comes to QuickBooks Self-Employed though, our only option is to make ways in which we can make it easier for ourselves. And the way in which I'm going to do that is look at how we can do this truing up of the income, so putting the expenses in the income, just like we're showing here, where we've got the expense down here and the extra income. I'm going to show you how you could achieve that on a month-by-month basis, therefore giving you an opportunity just to have to do this one transaction each and every month. And if you do it each and every month, you'll then be able to still keep the right information in there, but by doing it on a simpler basis. And I'm going to show you how to do that in an upcoming video. So if that's of interest to you, please make sure you like, subscribe, all that sort of stuff, so you don't miss out on how to treat this on a month-by-month basis. Also to note, I did this on a daily basis, but that's only because my eBay managed payment is set to pay out on a day-by-day basis. My advice to you is to follow the transaction that we've just done, so the truing up, based on when you have your payouts from eBay. If you can do it on that transactional basis, then you're going to keep yourself really up to date, and it's going to be nice and clean and tidy when it comes to making sure your bank reconciles and things like that. Obviously, if you can't do it that way, then keep an eye out for that video where we look at it on a month by month basis. And there we have it, look at eBay managed payments for QuickBooks Online Self-Employed. Now, if you are using Self-Employed, this might be the moment that makes it very much a benefit to you to move over to QuickBooks Online. If you are looking at doing that, do make sure you get in contact, because we can make sure you get the best deal and we can give you a preferential rate on actually getting QuickBooks. We've got a special offer on the moment where we'll make sure you're not losing out by upgrading to QuickBooks, the full version of QuickBooks, opposed to using QuickBooks Self-Employed. So make sure you utilize that offer. As I said, going forward, we're going to look at ways we can automate this a lot more to make it easier for you. At the moment, it's all brand new eBay managed payments, so we are going through a bit of a manual process page, but at the end of the day, the transactions are coming into the bank account correctly. We then just need to make sure that transaction comes in the bank account is then trued up to the right amount. And yeah, it seems like a pain, but it is something we have to do to make sure we're doing it correctly. But don't worry, I'm not going to leave it just here. I am going to find ways to make it more easier for you, more efficient for you, and we will make sure that you are making the best of it. Again, like I said on the other video, if all this is looking too much for you, do think about our friends over at Bofix, because they can actually do the bookkeeping for you for a lot less than you probably think it's going to be. And there you have it. There's a way of doing eBay managed payments within QuickBooks Self-Employed. Hopefully you found some use in this video. And also remember that the only reason I did this video was because you guys reached out to me and said, how do I do XYZ? And if you are still struggling in any aspect of it, use the comment section below to let me know exactly what I can do to make it easier for you. And why not let me know, why are you using QuickBooks Self-Employed for you running your eBay reselling business? What's the benefit to you? Let me know below so that then I can do a follow-up video explaining to everyone why QuickBooks Self-Employed is the right choice. My name's Aaron Patrick, and it's been a pleasure to do this video for you. I will see you in the next video, and bye for now. I say yeah. I told him I can be a fighter if you want. I'll be there to catch you if you fall. I can make it brighter when it starts. I told him I would do it all for you, and I know you do it for me too. I can be a fighter if you want. I can be a fighter. I can be a fighter. It's real, cause I can get him out of my head. I don't care what we do, everything's really new. Even if we stay in bed, my heart is saying yeah. You know I want him, nah. My heart is saying yeah.